perceive the images that Christ gives to us. Tom Nelson, who serves as a pastor in the Faith Church, is a good friend, has identified four distorted images of the church. I find them rather helpful because they're so memorable. First, he says that there are many Christians who view the Church of Jesus Christ as a gas station. In other words, it's a place where you fill up. Here's my spiritual tank, and it's running a bit low, and I'm getting near to empty. Let's get a good sermon, where can we go for that, and so forth and so on. That'll pay me up, and keep me going, and fuel me for the week. The church is a gas station. Maybe you've heard of a church, and I'll go ahead. Second, the church is a movie theater, a place where we get entertainment. Here's an out of escape. Here's a place where you can leave the troubles of your life at the door and come out after an hour or so smiling and feeling better than when you went in. A lot of Christians think of a church like a movie. Third, the church is a drugstore. A place where you fill a prescription that's going to deal with your pain. Where can I get something that's going to deal with my pain? A lot of Christians view the church simply at that therapeutic level. Fourth, the church is a big box retail. I like this one. Many people have this idea. You know, the church is a place like the big box retailer that offers the best products in a clean and safe environment for you and for your family. You know, what people are looking for in a church is often the same way as they think about the big box retailer, where you get great service, low price, and one stop. And for many people, the church is a kind of producer of programs. What do you have for my kids? What do you have for young people? And so forth and so on. Now, there's something in all of these images. There's reasons why people think in all of these ways. But seriously, as a community of people who want our minds, our hearts, and our lives to be shaped by the Bible, I want you to take in with me today that you won't find any of these pictures in the Word of God. All of them are distortions, and if you think about it, they have one thing in common. They're all about me. Did you notice that? Fill me up. Entertain me. Take away my pain. Give me the programs I'm looking for me and my family. It's about me. It's about what I get. It's pure consumerism, which is not surprising that is pervasive in our culture. I don't know about you, but I don't have any particular loyalty to a gas station, or a movie theater, or a drugstore, or a big box retailer. I move around when it comes to these things, just trying to get the best deal at any given time. And there are a lot of Christians like that too. They're drifting around from one thing to another, seeing what they can pick up here and there. They find it hard to settle because they have never really understood what the church is. And they miss so much as a result. So let's recognize that there are some very distorted and very destructive images of the church that are at work in many minds and hearts, especially in our culture today. And I want us in this series to move away from a self-centered, consumerist way of thinking about the church and to grasp from the New Testament what Christ says to us about what it is that he's calling us to be, what it means to be the church. So I hope you'll open your Bible then at Ephesians in chapter 1, where we begin today with the church as the body of Christ. Let's start at verse 18. Paul is praying that God will open our eyes, the eyes of believers, to see, verse 19, his incomparably great power for us who believe. Wonderful phrase. Let's pause there for a moment. God has power. God has great power. More than that, God has incomparably great power. There is nothing to compare the power of God with, the apostle says. You know, Satan has power, temptation that you experience has power, the government has power, the media has power, but there is no power that you could ever begin to compare with the power of God. It is an incomparably great power that is his. It's of an ultimate